Greeting in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the peace and the power of the Holy Spirit in the season of Lent. Today's text is taken from Isaiah chapter 59, verses 9 to 19.
Isaiah chapter 59. Therefore, justice is far from us, nor does righteousness overtake us. We look for light, but there is darkness, for brightness, but we walk in blackness. We grope for the wall like the blind, and we grope as if we had no eyes. We stumble at noonday as at twilight. We are as dead men in desolate places. We all growl like bears and moan sadly like doves. We look for justice, but there is none, for salvation, but it is far from us. For our transgressions are multiplied before you, and our sins testify against us. For our transgressions are with us, and as for our iniquities, we know them. In transgressing and lying against the Lord, and departing from our God, speaking oppression and revolt, conceiving and uttering from the heart words of falsehood. Justice is turned back, and righteousness stands afar off, for truth is fallen in the street, and equity cannot enter. So truth fails, and he who departs from evil makes himself a prey. Then the Lord saw it, and it displeased him that there was no justice. He saw that there was no man, and wondered that there was no intercessor. Therefore his own arm brought salvation for him, and his own righteousness it sustained him. For he put on righteousness as a breastplate, and a helmet of salvation on his head. He put on the garments of vengeance for clothing, and was clad with zeal as a cloak. According to their deeds, accordingly he will repay, fury to his adversaries, recompense to his enemies. The coastlands he will fully repay. So shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and his glory from the rising of the sun. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against him.
Now, before we go to the text today, let me give you some background of Isaiah 59. This text is from the third major section, chapter 56 to 66 of the book of Isaiah. Now, many scholars have concluded that these chapters reflect the situation of the community of Israel following the return from the Babylonian exile in 538 BC. So, following the return from Babylon, the people faced a new crisis. With no central government, there was a little leadership and little means of enforcing laws. With no temple, religious life at low. The wall of the Jerusalem is broken down and the gates were destroyed by fire. They were being bullied, attacked, and mocked by their enemy. They live in a disgraced state. Apathy, indifference, and cynicism grew until the people began to lose sight of who they were as the people of God. They say God was hidden from them. They began to doubt the future that God had promised. They began to challenge God of his power and love. But Prophet Isaiah answered them with an accusation. It is your iniquity. Your sins have hidden God from you. Now they have begun to be callous how they lift up being God's people. They treated other people unjustly. The previous chapter attacked the superficiality of the people's religion, particularly during their fasting and praying. Remember, a person's relationship to others reflects his relationship with God. So therefore, in verse 9, the people acknowledge that justice is far from them. Not because God is inactive, but because they have not advocated justice among themselves. Now, after hearing the warning of the prophet, the people responded to it in confession of their iniquities before God. They were blind, not seeing life's guiding light that revealed in the word of God. And God is faithful and just, and he is willing to forgive them, just like in 1 John chapter 1, verse 9, saying, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. I remember in my journey of following Jesus, sometimes he seems so far away from me. I pray, I felt nothing. I read my Bible, I heard nothing. I went to church, I experienced nothing. I saw the presence of God, yet he seems so distant. And why did God seem to elude me? How could he let me sacrifice all my efforts to come into his presence and yet never seem to show up? Have you ever felt this way? As I trudged through this spiritual dry time, eventually I heard God's voice. His message was undeniably clear. Ezra, I am not hiding from you, but you have been hiding from me. And before you can come into my presence and enjoy fellowship with me, you must uncover the secrets of your heart and confess the sins of your past. Now, the sins of the people have made the separation between God and them. Now, this is something that we do not understand and often forget. Sins separate us from God. Sin creates a barrier between God and us. Sin is not a small thing to God. To us, we do not see the gravity of sin. God, from the very beginning, was showing us the way of sin. When Adam and Eve sinned, separation occurred. They could not be in the presence of God any longer, nor be in the paradise of God. Sin separates. Further, God used the law of Moses to teach us about the way of sin by having an animal killed and sacrificed for the sins of the people. Now, even in this picture, the people did not approach God with their sacrificed animal. They only could approach a priest. The priest had to be ceremonial undefiled and purified to offer an animal to God on behalf of the people. Sin separates. Of course, God is absolutely displeased by what he sees in his creation. There is no justice. There is no righteousness. Everyone has turned away from him. No one does what he says. Now the problem is stated. Now there is no one to intercede on our behalf. We cannot save ourselves. We cannot approach God. We cannot reconcile ourselves to God. No one is able to address the serious sinfulness of humans. While sin disconnects us from God and grip us tightly in his coils, God stepped in to rescue us. In verse 16, he saw that there was no man to intercede. Then his own arm brought him salvation. In verse 20, and a redeemer will come to Zion, declared the Lord. Hallelujah! That's Jesus, for he is the Lamb of God. Today, as you read, fast, and pray, know that though our sin causes us to feel distant from Jesus, however, his love is never far from us. Take a moment to confess any uncovered sins, then thank God for sending Jesus to rescue us. May you experience the joy of your salvation today. Let us pray. Lord, I am in that place again, on my knees, laying my life out before you. Thank you that on the cross you cry, it is finished. Lord, you have done it. Forgiveness is complete. I can live forever in your grace, forever in your love. So I ask now for your forgiveness, for the wrongs that I have done and the things that I have neglected. I ask for your forgiveness for the people I have hurt along the way, and those who I have failed to love as you love. I ask for your forgiveness, that with your strength, I determine not to make these errors again. I receive your forgiveness. And by the power of your Holy Spirit, I walk away from everything I know to be wrong and embrace everything I know about you. For the kingdom, the power, and the glories are yours. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.